this back up and running again with commentary, which is great because I can explain some things that are happening right now in our storyline. Again, finally. So our upcoming pay-per-view is Wonderfest. I have 5 matches made so far for that matchup. Course, AJ Styles defeated Goldberg and Edge in a TLC triple threat at the last pay-per-view Tables, Ladders, and Chairs and became the new champion. There was also a number one contenders fatal four-way ladder match that night to determine who would face the winner of that match at Winterfest. The winner of that match was Bobby Lashley, so of course we're going to get Bobby Lashley versus AJ Styles at Winterfest. Roman Reigns has also found a new number one contender in the returning Daniel Bryan. Charlotte's number one contender has been named. It is going to be Shayna Baszler. So those 3 title matches are scheduled so far for Winterfest. Our other 2 matches are non-title matches. There is going to be a number one contenders match for the Women's Tag Team Championships to decide who will fight them at Royal Rumble. It's going to be either the team of Nia Jax and Tamina, or the team that sort of returned when Daniel Bryan did, of his wife Brie Bella and her sister Nikki. As well as we're going to have an 8-man tornado tag match between the 3 tag team champions. Did I press online? And the newly crowned kind of... There's a tag team that is separated on shows, but guess what? They both have titles, so they threw their name in the ring for this match. Cesaro and Sheamus are going to be in action together as well tonight, and we're going to talk about that match last. It's going to be Dolph Ziggler and Bobby Roode, the Raw Tag Team Championships champions, against the SmackDown Tag Team Champions, Jimmy and Jey Uso, against also the new NXT Tag Team Champions, Bobby Fish and Kyle O'Reilly of the Undisputed Era, and Cesaro and Sheamus, the respected $1 million champion in Cesaro, and the hardcore champion in Sheamus, The Bar, going at it in a fatal four-way tornado tag match at Winterfest. We're going to kick off by throwing them in an eight-man tag team match right now. We are also going to have 2 8-man ladder matches at Winterfest. 1 8-man and 1 8-woman match. We're going to determine some of the participants for that tonight. 3 of each. We're going to have 3 qualifying matches for the men and 3 qualifying matches for the women. 1-man and 1-woman has already qualified by winning last week's Mixed Max Challenge. The same will go for the winners of this week's Mixed Max Challenge. So, Gentleman Jack Gallagher and Lacey Evans are both already in their respective ladder matches. No! Why would it be Samoa Joe?
crowd just set the bar. They are the bar.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. And at a combined weight of 499 pounds, Cesaro and the Celtic Warrior Sheamus, the Bar.
If there's a more bruising tag team than Cesaro and Sheamus, I have yet to witness them.
The Swiss Cyborg Cesaro, the Celtic Warrior Sheamus, former enemies who've turned a shared love of fighting into becoming a dominant tag team. Here comes the Undisputed Era.
And at a combined weight of 397 pounds, the NXT Tag Team Champions, Bobby Fish and Kyle O'Reilly, Undisputed Era.
These were two men that had a reputation that preceded them after their success all over the world. But these are two men who have lived up to those expectations ever since showing up on NXT.
And debuting alongside Adam Cole at NXT TakeOver Brooklyn 3 with one goal in mind, to shock the system.
The Redragons. Looking at the future right there, gentlemen.
It's hard to argue with that point, Michael.
And their opponents first, from Hollywood, Florida, weighing in at 218 pounds, one half of the Raw Tag Team Champions, Dolph Ziggler.
This is a big match coming up here for Dolph Ziggler, guys. And he knows it, too. Look at the look of determination on his face.
Well, I'd say the champ is stepping into the ring tonight with an opposition eager to prove a point.
Yeah, but I would say the champ is just as eager to prove a point as well, maybe even more so.
Things just became absolutely glorious. Can I get a hallelujah?
And his partners from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, weighing in at 235 pounds, one half of the Raw Tag Team Champions, the Glorious Robert Roode,
former United States Champion. Held titles all over the world, but Roode said, "Nothing I have ever accomplished will hold a candle to what I do in WWE.
You look at a guy who's got tremendous work ethic. He's always the first guy at the arena, last guy to leave. Spends tremendous amount of time working on his physique, working on his in-ring ability, and you see the results each and every week.
Hang on, I'll be starting this match here in just a second.